Hello, friends. And today we're going to talk about Moscow Metro, Moscow Underground, Moscow Tube, whatever, and the marble, incredible marble in it. So, in the last video, we discussed about magnetron in Moscow Underground. This is one. This is the magnetron I talk. It's like the magnetron in one of the churches. It's really incredible, but let's talk about what else Metro is. And definitely for some people it's a place of meditation. Yeah, probably we can find Nirvana there. It's a nice place to listen to inside of us, to our spirit, to our energies and so on, to get some inspiration. No doubt, really. For some people it's a way to get from point A to point B, but there is honestly, for me, I went to Metro with one reason. For me, it's like kind of like time machine, you know. I wanna travel to the past and to understand how people who build it, how they lived, how they think, what they did, what for. Because for me, it's really obvious that this marble masonry, these stones and so on, were not created, built in 1930s, 1950s. It's really not possible. And I already talked, I already shown you a lot of different structures, but I will show you more. You don't need to listen to me, just watch and think. How it was built, how they did it. Always, in all of my videos, just ask how they build it. It's definitely not possible to do it today without 3D equipment, with like here on Pavelecka station, 3D equipment. It's marble, incredible marble. We cannot copy it today, no way. Just look how it's done. It doesn't matter what official narrative is saying. Just try to imagine how it was done without diamond disc. Why these strange pine cones everywhere on lightings? I will make another video about lightings in underground in Moscow Tube, and later maybe about St. Petersburg Metro underground. But now just watch how those tubes were done, why those arches everywhere, and why those light candles and holders this shape, why it's so complicated, and how country where many people were starving, you know, it's like Great Depression, but much worse in Soviet Union. We had the same shit because it was ruled by the same government. I mean global government. Not Roosevelt or Stalin or Hitler, whatever. We had global power ruling us from 19th century. And look how this all is built and done. And look at the marble and other stones. There are dozens of types of stones. And unique style for each station, and pine cones everywhere on lighting devices, because they were not created, designed for wires. It was free energy lighting and illumination. And look at the quality of those stone masonry. And this is definitely added. It's a cheap, how to say, terracotta. It's different color. And it's look artificial, it doesn't belong there. And look at this ship, definitely this portrait of this soldier, tank soldier, has no connection to the anything else, any other drawings. It's definitely artificial, and this tank guy's soldier was added later. And here I'm showing you the original decorations, because this Soviet soldier, I respect soldiers, but anyway, it's definitely, it was added later. When the whole metro, like in many other capitals, were digged out. And it was not built, definitely. Look at this beauty. It's another station. And it's definitely like another Greco-Roman temple. And I cannot imagine how it was built. And it's definitely not for wires. We see typical, we call it lustra, lighting device, illumination device, like in many castles, operas, and palaces. Very complicated for simple light device. And it definitely was not for candles. And definitely this is doesn't belong to Soviet Union. Because fascists could not be part of equipment or armory or ammunition of modern like Soviet army. And this also was added and drawn, painted later. I wish I could see what was there before those new paintings. And this one also has no connection to their, I know, Soviet, typical Soviet drawings and paintings. See for yourself. Pine cones, brass, candelabra, what we call candelabras. It's not candle holders, it's, I don't know how to say. It don't matter. It's too complicated. It's too hard to make. Unique design for each station, dozens of station, and sailings. And this picture of victory, our first victory after first battle, first invasion, and this sailings. It also has some purpose, some technological purpose. I don't know what is it for here, but definitely it looks like typical sailings in any cathedral. Any cathedral all over the world. Catholic cathedrals they call it, but they are also all over the world. And definitely there is no obvious rational reason to put those decorations there. And look at the quality. It's original, and it definitely has no connection to the Soviet Union, when official narrative claiming that it was built during Soviet time. No, it was digged out, and then they put some Soviet symbols to pretend that it was built when it was built officially, as official narrative is saying. We cannot do any of this today with this quality. I will explain why, but you know the answer. It's all marble. This drawing can be added later. It's painted. Really, just scratch the old one, or maybe even without scratching, and just paint new one over it. On the old one. But this design looks like somewhere in France, you know, in Opera City, theater, whatever. It looks like temple, candles, lighting device, illuminating device in many old photos of 19th century. But what the hell it has to do with Russian metro, Soviet metro? It looks like really, we are in church. Typical Roman, Italian, Spanian, whatever church. And even those stars, red stars, as I explained in previous video, it wasn't symbol of Satanism. Pentagram has no connection to religion, Satanism is also a religion. Look at those decorations. This looks like on top of any column, like sound speakers. It's a way from one station to another, walking, way walking path. And we see this. What for? Why? I have seen it in many, many places, but on top of the columns. And what is this for? Maybe just to put some advertisement, maybe. But maybe it had some equipment there previously. Who knows? I'm just speculating. But what is really obvious for me is this quality of masonry, this quality of very beautiful stones and decorations could not be done by, you know, it's not Soviet style. It's not communist style, definitely. It has no connection to the gigantism of Soviet time, as I can show you in many other places, like a mausoleum. Nothing rectangular, really. Our invaders has a symbol, the cube. And nothing is cubic here, nothing rectangular. Everything in style of our previous civilization, style of one global civilization, country, global architectural style. And we see this. This could be added later also, but this one, on sides of this vitrage, is original. This is definitely original. It's too difficult and complicated. And definitely, this is something too much just to hold the lamp. It's definitely not for lamp, it's not just lamp holder. And this one also, they edited it, they painted, they tried to erase it, but we still see what's left of it. We can even imagine, just imagine how beautiful it was before so-called restoration, because they tried to erase almost everything. What we see is really small part, 5% of what was before, and definitely the underground metro we can see is about, I think, 20% of really is there, somewhere down there. And look at the ceilings. It's arches. It's not flat ceilings like in any modern stations. And it's too complicated, all those decorations. And unique style for each. And this style is not communist, and it's not modern. And there is no way we can do anything like this even today. Even with 3D printers or equipment and so on. There is no stone equipment to do anything like we saw in metro. And this one is also marble, guys. It's not gypsum or any, I don't know how to say. But it's not something like we use, like concrete, you know. It's not something we pour. It's something we have to cut. I have no words to explain. And I have tears. Because I want to cry when I imagine how much we lost. How much our invaders destroyed. And keep on destroying, because they are ruling us. Even now, today. We have global power ruling the whole world. All countries. If somebody believes that we vote and we really elect Trump or Putin or whatever, Frau Merkel or Gandhi, it doesn't matter, really. We had civilization much better than a civilization we lived now. We had free energy, we had better connection, better than radio. We had communication and teleportation system like this one. It's another teleport. Not the one I've showed you before, but it's absolutely the same. Just a copy. And something was there. It's not the one I showed you in previous video. It's different. And there are many of them. So-called niches. We call it niche. Niche, whatever. And lighting devices. Lamps. Street lights. Like street lights everywhere. This one, exactly. And those flowers. Also not just for decoration. It has some technical purpose, making standing waves. It's kind of a meter to focus in one place to make standing wave. Because everything was full of energy. Good for us, good for health, good for our cells and brains. And now we lost it. Only few of us can feel the rest of it. What was left? What we had here 200 years ago. Like we go to any church and we can feel the energies from the past. Energies of the past. It has nothing to do to the somebody on the cross or any religion. It's all about energies of the place where churches are standing and energies of the past which still flowing there in many places. Like there are some energies still flowing in metro, in Moscow metro. And actually it's a lovely place. It's too crowded, I think. But you can imagine how many people were using it 200 years ago or longer. And there are many questions not answered. For example, those dead end. This fence. What for? This light. It's typical, but it's obvious that it was not designed for wires, for AC electricity. It was for free energy. And it was emitting, it is original, and it was emitting light without wires. With another kind of energy. And something, some equipment, I guess, was behind this cave or fence, whatever. And this is original light. And it's still standing. We can still see it. And it's another station. I will try to show you maybe 5-10 of them. But there are dozens of them. Yeah, they put this symbol of Soviet Union. But it doesn't look like it belongs here. And this one, definitely original. Those domes with this symbol. This symbol also was everywhere. In USA, in South Africa, in Australia, and here in Russia, many places. Because star, pentagram, it has nothing to do with Soviet Union or Satanism. And so on, because all symbols is not what we are told. Every symbol has some function. And this is also original. Look at this. Let me continue. All stars are perfect resonators. And those flowers also are resonating and sending energies. Salients like in cathedrals. In many metro stations, salients like in cathedrals. Is it coincidence? I don't think so, really. There are many, many things I want to show you, but I'm limited in time, so doesn't matter what I'm saying, just watch and think, analyze and feel the energies. It's just a typical sitting place, but try to imagine and understand how complicated, how difficult to build it today with those decorations. It's perfect marble, guys. It's not something liquid we put it on form, on shape. And it's solid. No, it's not concrete. It's marble. And there is no way we can do it today. Even with the equipment of 21st century, it's a little bit difficult. But we see many of them in line. It's like, you know, it was piece of cake. It was really easy to do it, to customize it for each and every station. Different style, different, you know, shape, form, and so on. And make it unique marble decoration for each station. Make 20 sitting place for one, 50 different columns, the same columns for another station, but different shape, and so on. It was easy. It was some kind of technology we lost today. Today we cannot do it anything like this. We just cannot copy it. All we have to do just to watch and feel sorrow and depression a little bit. I hope you will understand my feelings. This is new, definitely new, to show that it belongs here, that it has some connection to the Soviet Union. No, I'm not buying it. It was built long before. Like this one. It's definitely like Greco-Roman temple. The same style. All over the planet. All over the earth. And look at the fruits. It's the fruits. Definitely not from the fantasy of some Soviet worker. It's definitely something original. And looks like typical fruit 200 years ago. But I don't see any fruit looking like this today. Something similar sometimes. But we lost most of the fruits from the past. And again, another perfect, beautiful dome. And something was there in the center. And we lost it. And it's definitely fractal design, and it's definitely for standing waves. And we had some waves and toroids in the center, energy toroids, like in many places in metro. And we have this half circle to accept the wave, again to accept vibrations and redirect it. It's a waveguide, because it's also like magnetron style. And it's definitely also for free energy, this light. And on top of the column, like everywhere in the world, in every temple, just a second. It's also too complicated for simple light. Here, again, like sound emitting device with spirals and so on. Like on top of many columns in thousands of so-called ancient temples. All over the world, in Greece, in Rome, in Europe, everywhere. Another not Soviet style. And let's go out, because it's too much for going underground. It's typical entrance to the metro. I will show you more, maybe. But they all look like, you know, church or temple. And it's definitely no sign of Soviet style. All this building was built long before. It's Museum of Moscow. Just watch. And it has also nothing to do with typically Russian style. It's typical Greco-Roman style with fascists in the fence, like everywhere. Just fascists. But we are not in Rome, we are not in Italy. But we have lions, and we have fascists, and so on. That's all for today. I think enough information for you. Please write in comments what do you think about all of it. And thank you for your attention. And see you next time, because it's definitely to be continued. One way or another. We'll find the truth, I think. We must. And we will win. We will win our enemy and our invader. We will destroy her. Thank you for your attention. and maybe a little bit more of your time, I will show you the roof of this place. The style of this fence, the style of this building, the size of entrance and doors also means something. But this Lego, also like I've seen in Kostroma, in St. Petersburg and some other places, it also means something. Something emitting. I don't know what for this Lego is. If you have any ideas, please write in comments. And this place, they claim it was built in 20th century, but I am not buying it, like this building also from before Mudflap. Thank you and bye.